Hello everyone, this is Nitpicking Nerd, and today's video will be an extreme nitpick of a few minor details in the latest episode of Star Trek Discovery. And I made a very long review of this episode a few days ago, but I didn't mention the details I'm going to talk about now. So first of all, the very opening of this episode has the narration by Michael Burnham, which is basically a message that she's transmitting for the Discovery for when it shows up. They will hear her message. And as we hear this recording, we also see her hanging around with Book, and then her narration or transmission gets interrupted by a hail she receives, probably from that guy who waited 40 years for her to show up, so he sent her a message that he detected the Discovery. But what's so weird about this scene is how come her recording, her message to Discovery, gets interrupted by something that we see happening in a scene in which she's not narrating that, meaning she recorded it previously. And in the scene that we see visually of her hanging around with Book, she's not recording the message now. So how can the message get interrupted by something that happens now in the scene we're looking at if that message was recorded previously? So the way they edited it all together doesn't make any sense, unless she was imagining the whole thing, like she was thinking about how to narrate her message while she was hanging around with Book, and then her thought process got interrupted. So that's how it looks like. And also her narrations are some of the worst parts of the show. They're always over-dramatic, over-emotional, and always with that kind of monotone monologue and whispering things. And it's like, oh, I missed you so much. I love you, the crew of the Discovery. I keep waiting for you to show up. And, I mean, she's sending an official transmission to her starship. So shouldn't it sound kind of more professional, more official letter and not kind of an emotional log? Is she recording a diary about her emotions, or is it a transmission for Discovery? So that whole part is kind of annoying, especially her getting interrupted when what we see visually and what we hear are obviously from two separate events, and yet the episode treats it as if it happened simultaneously. So that's kind of one of those illogical moments of the show. And I'm really curious if it was written that way in the script itself, or is it something that kind of happened in the editing process? So I would be interested to see the script of this episode, to see how it was written and how come it wasn't picked up as being illogical by anyone. The other strange moments I wanted to talk about were in that montage that the episode showed us about what she was doing that whole year, which was, by the way, kind of too short. Like, I thought it's going to take up a lot more time of the episode, because, you know, a whole year you can show so much interesting stuff, and instead we see only like half a minute of screen time of all the time that passed. Especially they used her hair, they showed her hair is getting longer and longer to indicate the passage of time, and in the final haircut she gets, her hair looks way too long, like it would take much longer than a whole year to grow that. But it's something I can dismiss, because, you know, this is science fiction, they are supposed to have advanced medical technology, so I can believe that she did something to accelerate her hair, or maybe it's artificial hair or something. But a few interesting visual things I noticed in that scene of her standing on some alien planet. We see a giant moon in the sky, and I remember at first glance I immediately thought, is that on Earth? Because it kind of looks like our own moon, and yet it looks to be way too big, like it's huge, so it cannot be on Earth. So is this some kind of artificial station near Earth or something? But then later in the episode she says that she was unable to contact Earth because it's too far, so it couldn't have been Earth. So why did that moon look so similar to our own moon? And, you know, this is something that people can easily recognize because we see it every day outside. So it's not some obscure image that only astronomy fans would pick on. This is something that anyone would notice. Hey, is that our own moon? Because it looks kind of similar. So that's something I went back to check. So I pulled an image of our own moon and I put it next to it and I started looking at the minor details, and I spinned it around until I could see the similarities, and then I cut it out in Photoshop and I superimposed it and started making it transparent, and then you can clearly see all the similar patterns, that this is indeed our own moon. You can see the same craters and everything. So that kind of pissed me off, because, you know, how lazy is that? Couldn't they at least Photoshop it a little bit so that it would be less recognizable? Like, why not mirror it? Why not move around some of those patterns? You can do it easily with Photoshop. I could do it in literally 1 minute to change the whole landscape of the moon so that it wouldn't be so recognizable. And they did do that a little bit, like some of it is a little bit distorted and they obviously rotated the moon, but they should have done more with that. And in one of the other shots, when we see a close-up of Michael, I tried to compare it to the moon again, and it was much harder. So obviously in this shot they did rearrange all the patterns, but it doesn't look like the previous shot. So this is an even bigger continuity mistake now, because the moon or planet that they're showing us in the sky is not consistent from one shot to the other shot a few seconds later. So that's also kind of a problem. They should have done that in all the shots. And of course it's something that people are not meant to notice, but my brain kind of noticed it right away without me looking at the details. Like, it just looks too much like our own moon. And it's all because they were too lazy to change it so it won't be so recognizable, or at least, you know, do some tweaks in Photoshop before they use that footage, and to keep it consistent in the shots in the same episode. So all of that created a needless question mark. Like, it made me wonder for a moment, where the hell is she? Why do we see the moon on some other planet? Did someone steal the moon or something? Maybe during the Bourne it accidentally got sent off flying. Maybe someone stole it because the moon has some dilithium in it or something. So someone stole Earth's moon and pulled it away to some other quadrant. That's the only way to explain it in universe, I guess. So I can't come up with excuses like that and theories to explain it. And maybe that would have been a fun story, you know. Maybe that's why Michael visited that planet specifically, because she found out that somehow it has Earth's moon in its orbit, and so she was curious how did that happen, and that's why she visited that place. That actually could have been an interesting part of the story. And also later, when we do see the real Earth, we see that it has no moon suddenly, even though in this very same show previously the moon was always very close to Earth, much closer than how it is in reality. So suddenly it has no moon. And so I remember thinking, will they show us the moon? Will they explain what happened with the moon colonies and all of that? And yet they totally forgot about that in this episode. And when we see Earth, we don't see the moon anywhere near it, and it only has a shield around Earth itself, and apparently they lost contact with all other planets in the solar system. So I was wondering what the hell happened with the moon, and it was never explained. And yet the beginning of the same episode, we see our moon in some distant sector of the galaxy, which Michael says she couldn't get to Earth from. And so that creates kind of unnecessary confusion and kind of a WTF moment for no reason, and all of it simply because of the laziness of whoever made the special effect. And that's why I find it kind of annoying. Of course, it's not the only show or movie that did that. I think in one episode of TNG, when Data was stuck on some primitive planet and he looked out in the sky, we can see a moon that also looks kind of like, almost exactly like our own moon. So someone was lazy there too, I think. And also in the movie Stargate, when they show us the three moons in the sky, all of them look exactly like our own moon, only rotated differently, but it's our own moon and it's very obvious to anyone. And that's something that always annoyed me in that movie, because they were so lazy they couldn't at least make it look a little bit different except for rotating it or mirroring it. And so that shot always kind of annoyed me, and so I'm similarly annoyed in this scene of the episode in which we clearly see our own moon in the sky on some alien planet. And we also see some strange alien wearing a dress, but that's another story. So let me know what you think in the comments below and we can discuss it, and I'll see you all next time.